Hello students, welcome to Auja classes Smartness in Education. Today we are going to cover the next concept of quadrilaterals, in which we will talk about the different properties of a parallelogram. Let us see first of all an activity in which we have taken a parallelogram ABCD which has been cut across its diagonal AC. If we take a parallelogram and we cut it across its diagonal, then we obtain two triangles ABC and ACD in such a manner that these two triangles overlap on each other. So the triangle ABC and triangle ADC are so obtained, if they are placed on each other, then they will completely cover each other and there will be no space left. So we can say that if a parallelogram is divided into two triangles through its diagonal, then two congruent triangles, triangle ABC and triangle ADC, are obtained. Or we can say that if we cut a parallelogram across one of its diagonals, then two triangles are obtained and these two triangles will be congruent. Now let us see a theorem based upon this activity, which says a diagonal of a parallelogram divides it into two congruent triangles. In the figure, it is given that a parallelogram ABCD, in which the sides AB and CD are parallel to each other and AC is the transversal. So to prove this theorem, let us write the given parameters. A parallelogram ABCD, in which AB is parallel to CD and AC is transversal, and it is also given to us that AD is parallel to BC. Now we have to prove that the triangles so obtained, that means ABC, is congruent to triangle ADC. Now to prove this, we will take triangle ABC and triangle ADC. Now by seeing the figure carefully, we have two pairs of alternate interior angles. Since AB is parallel to DC, so that angle BAC is equal to angle ACD, which form the pair of alternate interior angles. Similarly, AD is parallel to BC, and again AC we have as a transversal. So angle we have BCA is equal to angle BCA is equal to angle DAC, which also form the pair of alternate interior angles, and we have AC is equals to AC, that is common. So that by angle side angle rule of congruence, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle ADC. So that by angle side angle rule of congruence triangle ABC is congruent to triangle ADC. So we can say that a diagonal of a parallelogram divides it into two congruent triangles. Therefore, we can say that a diagonal of a parallelogram divides it into two congruent triangles. Now, in the next lectures, we will talk about the other properties of the parallelogram. Thank you.